Hello everyone, my name is Ben Yumata and I am the owner of Grubbies Burgers and Hawaiian BBQ. To start, I don't even know where to begin.
Tonight, honestly, it's not about making money. Tonight is about celebrating, because I really want to celebrate this one. We've been grinding it for the last 6 months to get the shop open, so I just want you all to come down, enjoy yourself, have a good time, come and get some food, come and listen to the band, because the band's amazing. But I'm just so thankful. So if I can't reply to all your messages, because I'm getting quite a lot of messages, just know that I love you and I'm so thankful. I'm really thankful for all your love and support. So I'll see you all tonight. I'll try my best to do what I can to provide the best service I can. So thank you so much, everyone. I love you. Welcome to another episode of The Block. So we got a lot done today. We've smashed out all the walls, the floors, and ripped up all the carpet and all that stuff, and getting everything ready for the new liquid paint and everything like that. There's nothing much we can really do at the moment until we get the floor plan approved by the council, so we can just get little things done. But we've had a big roadblock, a huge roadblock, so it hasn't been a good day today. I've met with the plumbers, and what we need done for our space to be compliant with the council stuff and the council approval stuff is, it's gonna cost us up to $10,000 to $15,000. So sorry for my fat lip, boy. As you all know, I'm an NRL player and I got hurt playing. So before the actual concept came, a friend of ours, they had a business in this courtyard, and they asked us to do, because I was doing food videos and all that kind of stuff, and I was perfecting these burgers, these smash patty burgers. This is going back to 2 years or 2.5 years, probably 3 years, I would say. Went back, we were doing these patties at home, and the boys said, come and set up a grill out here in the courtyard and sell it to our customers. So I thought, all right, then this could be cool. We posted up an ad on Facebook and all that, and we set up our little grill out here, and man, I think we kicked off at 6 p.m. 6 p.m. we had a massive line of people waiting for these burgers. No one's even had them before. People came and we sold 200 burgers in 45 minutes, I think we did. And it was a massive night. There was a DJ, there was a great night. It was amazing. Probably the most perfect start. And when that happened, I kind of like a light bulb moment, you know, went off my head. I was like, oh, maybe we got something here. And so I went home to my wife and I said, babe, I think we got something here. But my wife is always just play it safe, just work normal job. It's right. It's just, you're just too ambitious sometimes. Da 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 da. So I was like, all right then, sweet.
It's been a bit of a journey, but I'm truly grateful for everyone, all the love and support I've received in the last 6 months getting this here. I'm really happy to see everyone here tonight. I didn't think I was going to see a line like this, but I'm truly grateful and I'm thankful for everyone to be here tonight. Even though it's raining, we're still going to rock it out, right? The boys are going to smash it. We've got some more marquees coming. But yeah, food's about 2 minutes ready, so when that door opens, we're on, alright? So, but thank you everyone.
So I kind of sat back and it was just one of those things, I just couldn't let it go. It was like burning inside me. I had this feeling like there's something more to this, and I think there's something there for us, but I couldn't let it go. So I sneakily went behind her back and I started getting things in motion. I started looking at what it's going to take for us to open this thing. I was looking at locations. I was doing all the homework I could possibly do to make this thing happen. And as I was doing homework and as I was going through things, it was just, you know, that I was intrigued, and I just, that fire to do it just kept growing and growing and growing. And behind her back, I was actually full setting up this whole business, kitchen, full on doing it. I met with the landlords. The landlords gave me a letter of offer that I had to fill out. And then there's a final meeting. We had to meet the lawyers and sign this form. And I called my wife, said, babe, we've got to see the lawyers. We've got to see the lawyers. She's like, what's going on? I said, babe, let's go see the lawyers. She's like, what lawyer? So I took her down and the lawyer sat us down. She's like, oh, all good guys, the lease is all ready, the shop's ready, you just gotta sign here. She looked at me with this like this pure anger, and I could tell that she wanted to. And anyways, we signed the lease and she signed it, and thank you, shook hands, all done now. So we come out of the lawyer's office and we walk across the road and we come here to the shop, and I show her what I got. And this is old, rundown, like old salvo that's just like disgusting. It was half demolished. It was just, so she couldn't see what I could see, and she was just pretty. So anyways, I said, don't worry babe, I'm not gonna bother you with it. We've got a bit of money there, let me use a little bit of that money, and then we'll do the fit out and everything, and I won't bother you.
I'll just keep, you know, doing what you're doing and I'll do this. Anyways, that little bit of money that I had was gone within the week. I as much as homework I did for it, it didn't prepare me for what actually came.
It's like a huge roadblock for us, because I don't just have 10-15,000 budget for the plumbing alone, you know, for other things, but not just the plumbing. So I'm gonna have a meeting with the landlord tomorrow and just figure out if they can meet us halfway or if they can jump in the party with this, because some of these costs just too crazy. But yeah, it's a learning curve. We're learning as we go and getting everything done, but I got a feeling that everything will work out, so fingers crossed. If not, click the link below for the GoFundMe page and donate to the GoFundMe. But stay tuned, I'll keep you updated with everything. Yeah, good news, we just had our meeting with our landlords and with our builder, and we've come to agreement. So the landlords are gonna take over, take care of all the plumbing and all that stuff, so they're gonna front the cost for all that, and we're just gonna keep rocking and rolling, pushing on. So really good news. You know, it was a bit touch and go there for a second. I think we were gonna we were looking at going elsewhere and trying to find a spot that the plumbing was already done for us, instead of fitting this one. So really good news, really happy. I was a bit down yesterday, I was a bit suki lala, but everything's all good. So we're still all guns blazing, the boys are on, nerves on, they're just patching on the walls today, getting ready for sanding and painting. So the next 24 hours this thing will be all spick and span. So let's go.
We originally was meant to be just burgers. Originally was just meant to be burgers, but I needed something that was different and something that's different from all the other burger chains that are around here. So what's my angle, what's my something different? And I really love the Hawaiian cuisine and I enjoy that, and as being Samoan too, it's easy to transition and eat that kind of food as well. Well, I looked into it and there was actually none. There was actually no Hawaiian barbecue places in Australia. There was one that was closing, but there was none. So I thought that was my angle. But I wasn't going to do it until we perfected it. So it was a lot of teething to get through it all and kind of get the product that we have now. I think it was about 2 years, to be honest, of cooking and experimenting and trying things. And I think we finally got a product that we were able to sell. And that's how it all happened. But the name, Grubbies, well, I come back from football background, a bit of a problem on the field. It just rolled off the tongue well, and it was something that was easy to market, something that could roll off the tongue easy, something that could, hey, let's go down to Grubbies kind of thing. So that's how we came with the name of Grubbies Burgers and Hawaiian Barbecue.
Morning. It's currently 5:45 a.m. and I'm just heading over to the shop now. We had a real late night last night. We went to floor grind all the floors. And get it all leveled out, ready for the flooring guys to come. So shout out to my boy Morris, he was there late last night getting everything prepped. But I'm meeting our painter this morning, Mr. Sean Inu, to roll out all the walls. So yeah, we're going pretty well, everything's moving smoothly after that big plumbing debacle. But yeah, it's a beautiful day today, the heavens are shining on us, so let's go. Hopefully it everything works out well today, because I've done the patching and sanding, so Sean hasn't seen it yet, so hopefully it's up to his standards so he can paint it. So let's go, baby.
We're on. Walls are getting painted up. Sully, that was my patching. Do you approve? Yes, chuck it on the resume, baby. Chuck it on the resume.
We have council fees through the roof. We had building certifiers. We needed to get hydraulic plans for the plumbers. There was no kitchen in here before, and I thought you could just come and put a kitchen there, but you can't. There's so much council regulations and things that you have to do to open a kitchen. So all the plumbing had to be upgraded, all the power had to be upgraded, pretty much everything for it to get to a commercial kitchen standard. And that costs a lot more money than what I had, but I'm already in this. I think I signed a 3-year lease with another option for another 3 years. I've already spent all the money I can on half of what we needed to do, and so it was tough. It was really hard. I had a lot of friends that were builders and plumbers and sparkies. They all came and helped me out to get things going. But even with that, it was still really, really expensive. And that period, it took us, we opened April the 17th, 2021. I signed the lease in October 2020. It took me from October to April to get this thing going. And it was because I pretty much had to do most of the labor work myself. So whatever I could save money on labor-wise in regards to painting, digging, drilling holes and doing all fit-out stuff, the tradies would allow me to do it to a certain extent, because obviously quality was at the forefront of what they wanted to do. So they'd just give me bits and pieces, but it was tough.
What up? So, well, the plumbers are in, the gas fitters are in, but the problem is that there's this big-ass hole that's got a... Sorry, I don't know if you can see that. There's a big-ass hole there that's got to be drilled out. So it's gonna cost us heaps of money, but if the plumber said if I could do it myself, it would be a lot cheaper. So I got this big ass gun, baby. I'm just gonna drill with a big ass hole. So, oh, wish me luck, baby. Yeah! Yo! Yo! Fafkai!
Being a husband and a father, you know, we're the protectors, we're the providers, and I had to pretty much take everything we have, take it away from them, put it all on this, and our family was so vulnerable at that point. It was like anything could happen to my family. I had nothing for us. I just put everything in there, so I was pretty scared and pretty sick, but we worked through it. I'm pretty resilient when it comes to that kind of stuff. I feel like I'm pretty strong between the ears, and we worked through it. But while this whole thing happened, the 6 months of just hell, my wife had no idea. She didn't know what I was going through. I never brought any of the issues I had home to her, because she was already angry at me for opening the shop without her. So I never took any problems home with her. I never reached out to my family, even to my friends. I just kind of took it on the chin, and I just try to find ways to work around it, because of my belief. I just believe that I had something really good.
Morning. It's bright and early today on a Monday morning, about 6:30 a.m. Just heading to Bunnings to meet our builder. We're gonna go and have a look at all the stuff we need for this and that, look at countertops, da da da. Then we're gonna head back to the shop and build their subdividing wall and the back wall and all that in the counter area. So we're moving along pretty smoothly, everything's going pretty well. We're still waiting for that council approval, but it is what it is. So yeah, we're just doing as much as we can while we can, but there's nothing much we can do. So hopefully we can get the walls and floors done. We're not really meant to be doing the flooring, but yeah, council's taking too long, so let's just do it anyway. But yeah, let's go, big day ahead today, let's go.
Morning.
We're here at Bunnings. Got to pick up all our materials today for building our walls, subdividing walls, counter benches, everything like that. As always, I'm dressed apart. Shout out to our builders. Just meeting my builder here, Jetland Construction. He's doing our fit up, my boy Zaki. He's doing everything and getting all our council stuff done. Such a good boy, such a hard worker.
Morning.
Here's our man, hey, Big Zaki. How's it going?
Good.
Are we on today or what?
We are on.
Something about going to Bunnings, eh? It's like, you know, you just feel like the man in there. You know, we go there, but you know what I mean? Like going with a builder and they're buying all this stuff, like the proper, like stuff that you wouldn't usually grab, you know? Like you just feel like the man. That's the only reason why I chucked the shirt on today, just so I can go there being the man.
Food's always been my passion, and I always say that food is my way of serving people. I like to serve people, I like to serve others, and food's probably the best way I knew how to. Something I probably didn't ever want to do, because I understand in the food industry there's always hierarchies from head chef down to the little cleaners, and I struggle a little bit with that. So I never wanted to, but the opportunity came up. I'm grateful that I did take the opportunity, but yeah, that's how it all came about. It was just my passion to serve others, and that's the best way I knew how to. So the fit out process of this whole thing was probably the biggest lose. We faced issues that a lot of people probably wouldn't understand for even us to open. This shop is not fit to have a kitchen in it. This shop runs off single phase power. If anyone knows how power works, it runs off single phase. I actually need three phase power. But the quote I got, and we only found that out like 2 weeks before we opened, that we needed an upgrade because we fit out everything. We got all our equipment in here, all the ovens, all the grills, all the canopy, the extraction fan. We plugged it all in and the power didn't work. We had too much, not enough juice. So we had to upgrade, but we got a quote for $15,000 I didn't have that money. So we had spent all the money that we had and we had a couple of weeks out from opening. But we just persevered. I actually, 2 weeks out before opening, we chucked the grill out here. And we just started making Philly cheesesteaks just to bump out and make something. It was just things like that, just being resilient, being trying to find ways that we could. And that was the first time we did Philly cheesesteak night was Grubbies wasn't even open. It was like just grab a grill, set it up out here, and man, it just took off. And we got the money to go to the next thing, got to the next thing, and going home and not being able to talk to anyone about this or being able to, because I didn't want to put pressure on my family as well, my parents or my siblings or my friends. I just had to like keep things, you know, underwater and just keep and keep being resilient and trying to figure out problems with no money pretty much. That were probably the lowest of the lows.
Yo, what up? We're just here about to lay this floor down. My man Morris. Let's say hello, man. Say hello to the fans. There's 3 million viewers.
We went through hell for 6 months, and I just on the day of opening, I remember having a moment in the car, and I was just like this is it. I don't know if people are gonna come. I don't know if it's gonna be empty. I don't know if people are gonna even like the food. I don't know. I have no idea other than what we did last year. We opened on that Saturday at 3 p.m. and I think the line started at probably 1:30 or 2 o'clock. There was a line wrapping around the building, and that was like a huge high for me. It was like all that hard work, all that pain we went through, there was something on the other side for us. But I didn't understand at that moment. Now, holy, I am so thankful. I'm thankful that I took the risk. I'm so thankful that everyone came and supported and continued to support, because it wasn't as easy as, I think, yeah, it was probably the hardest. We took it the most hardest possible way there is to open a shop, open a kitchen. We went the hard way of everything. Originally, even our kitchen, all our equipment, we opened during COVID. So we opened during COVID, and a lot of restaurants were closing down during that time. And I tried to open the shop during COVID. So with the budget we had, all I was doing was I was going around to different shops that were closed down, and I was buying all their equipment, like cheap. Nando's closed down, we got their big grill to do all our Hawaiian barbecue, big grill, and I think I paid $500 or something, where that thing's worth about 10 grand. So these little things and just being resilient during that time, during the low time, that was huge for us. And it was like, just, yeah, it was, the low was really, really low. But when it came to that grand opening, it's just been complete highs, even till now. Like, it just hasn't stopped. It's been a year. And the numbers that we're doing at the beginning with the volume of people, it just hasn't stopped. So I am, as much as the lows were really low, the highs are really high. So I'm really happy about how we've been going.
How we going, Martin?
Going, mate.
How's the job? Is this an easy job or a hard job?
It's a long job.
Mikey Sabos. We're vlogging this whole journey from the beginning to the end. This is our Sparkies, Mikey and Martin. They hail from the villages of Beijing and Wuhan. These guys are on. Yeah, this is up in the roof, pretty much, and they're just dropping all our alley lights. They're mocking me because I can't fit through this manhole. Yeah. These guys, they're fat shaming me now. Oh, okay. Bro, it's politically incorrect to fat shame people these days, bro.
Alright.
Alright, Karen.
Alright, alright, here you go.
They're on. They're on.
Ah, they're getting paid in kickboarders, dude. That's the only problem. Well, that's the road.
So my wife, she finally came around and she was like happy and excited for us. Once I did all the fit out and I brought her, I said, babe, remember when you came to the shop, it was this old ugly thing? when you came to the shop and it was this old ugly building, I want you to come again. And I went and picked up my wife and kids and we came and all this was done. And she hadn't seen it. She never came. She hadn't seen it. So when she finally came, she was just like, then she was excited and then she believed. And you know, the sense of belief, I think the belief was always there, but she was just not.
What up? Man, how old I am? Yeah, we like, what a good day today we had. Today we got it all, we got all the walls up, got it all sheeted and plastered, getting ready for sanding tomorrow, and sanding and painting, and then also the tilers are coming in tomorrow to bang out the tiles, and the sparkies are coming to finish off. So it's pretty much all guns blazing at the moment, everything's pretty much rocking and rolling. Yeah, we're getting there. We found the plumber and all that, and so yeah, man, I'm honestly grateful for all the help I'm getting. You know, I've got, you know, I have heaps of friends, and my wife gets annoyed at me because I got, like, my wife gets annoyed at me so for all the, like, the amount of friends I have. But honestly, I'm so grateful for every single one of you. You know, some people are offering me help and some people are just turning up and doing the work and not expecting anything in return. So you know, it's not going unnoticed. You know, I'm paying people where I can, I'm giving people everything I got where I can, and it's just been, it's been a blessing, and I'm so thankful. So I've had some real big ups and downs and some real trials, as you can see. But yeah, everyone, my family, my friends are just getting involved. They just want to make this happen. So it has to happen because I owe them. I owe them so much. I owe them to make it work, and I owe them to give it my best shot, because you know, people believe in me, and people are donating their time, their money, their trade, their craft, their talents. They're donating it all to me to make this happen because they believe. So I owe you, and I owe everyone that's helped. You know, I owe you by trying my best to try and make this work. So yeah, if you're watching this, just know that it's been one hell of a ride. But we're so close, and I'm so happy.
I want to say a massive thank you to a lot of the tradies that came through and done what they did for a fraction of the price just to make this happen, because I think they believed in me, and I'm like really, really grateful for everyone. And well, here we are, a year on.
Hey, man, the big man, you should know this guy, he's been doing the pop-ups with me, my boy Giff. He's in there giving me a hand today. We got all the sanding, the tiles are done, so we got all the sanding and painting waiting for our boys to come back with painting, but we're getting there, baby, we're getting there, slowly but surely.
I'm a big community guy. So a lot of people that they know me, I love my community, I love helping people. And yeah, I think even starting this shop, I think it was predestined for me. I think all this happened for a reason, for us to sit up out here, have a crack, for the shop to actually close down and come available for us in the time that it did. I think it all happened for a reason. I think opening here in Ipswich and Goodna in the 43, I think it was all part of the plan that was laid out for me. So yeah, I feel at home. We do have opportunity to move to a bigger shop because we actually need bigger space, because we just, with the amount of volume and people that come through, it's actually quite ridiculous. The numbers and the weight of food that we sell is just ridiculous.
Yeah, but we're getting there. It's, yeah, it's been tough. It's been so many roller coasters, so many hiccups, but we're getting there. It's yeah, slowly but surely we're getting there. So I'm happy with how everything's turning out, and let's go.
The staff have figured out a way to make it work in this small kitchen, and I love it, and it's there's a lot of sentimental like value for me with the shop. So I think I'll keep it. I think we'll stay. There's opportunities around in other shopping centers for us, a lot bigger, but I don't know, the courtyard's amazing, and people enjoy this place, especially when they have live entertainment. So yeah, I think this shop is important, and where how we started is important. I don't know, this shop might be a museum one day for us. We'll see.
Follow me, baby. The pain is on, baby. The boy Sean's back. Welcome back, painter. We've chosen to go with black and yellow to kind of go with our logo. And also because It's the paint we can get for free. It was the paint that we could get for free, bro. So, nah, I'm pretty happy I was setting up. It looks a bit dark, but once all the LED lights and everything pop on, then it'll shine. And all the menu boards, pretty much all along there. So, it's coming along. It's getting there.
Now my staff, they will tell you themselves that I'm really, really strict. I'm fun, I have fun, we do it all. I look after my staff 100%, but they know that there's a certain standard of food quality that I have, that it just has to be. There's no ifs, buts, or maybe. If we don't have it, I'll take it off the menu because I'm not gonna substitute anything or anything. It's just, I actually care how the food comes out. Like, that is me on a plate, that is us on a plate, that's my family on a plate. So I care how it comes out, and that's how I want Grubbies to be represented. I just want everyone to know that food is quality and there's no shortcuts taken here. I also want Grubbies to be known for somewhere, a safe zone for someone, for anyone. You know, you've all had it happen to you before. You got to pay for your food and your card declines, and you're all embarrassed and everything. But not here, Grubbies. It declines, I don't care. See you later. Here's your food. Sort it out next time. And that's kind of how I was raised, and that's how I want my business to continue to be. I know people know that that's a thing, and they're starting to be a bit tricky with it, but. The good will do good. So those kind of things I want Grubbies to be represented by. So yeah, it's important to me that that's how we are to the world.
Big cleanup day, getting everything out. The boys are cleaning the dirt, and with the sign lights up, it's got LED lights, so it will light up. What up, everyone? It's your boy Nacho. Welcome to Grubbies. I'm so thankful for everyone coming down. Let's go.
There was a moment when we opened the doors and we were just getting demolished by orders. It was just like, we're in the back, so I couldn't really see what was going on. I only saw the beginning when I saw the line, but I didn't realize how busy it was. And when I came out and looked, and my wife looked, I just looked at her, and she just had this look on her face, like she's so sorry. She's so sorry for not believing from the start. I'm still writing it after too. I'm still using that little get out of jail card sometimes. But yeah, that was a good high to kind of look at my wife and to see, not so much I told you so, but like to see her look at me with proud eyes. You know, she looked at me with these eyes that she was proud of what we've done and what we've achieved and all the hardship we went through and all that. So yeah, that was a really good one for me personally. For me, Grubbies, no matter how big we grow, I have no idea what's going to happen with us, if we're going to be a 50 store franchise multi company, I don't know. But one thing will remain the same is that standard that I've set for us, and that is, I don't want any additives or preservatives, or this is going on camera, so there's no pulling out of this. I don't want any crap in our food. I don't want, a lot of these food suppliers like to bulk things up and add things. I don't want any of it. Everything that we make in here is all fresh. It's all handmade in here. All the minstrels are rolled, everything's made fresh. Our bread, our buns, if you haven't had a Grubbies burger, our buns is one of the highlights of the bread. They're made fresh. Sometimes we get them and they're still warm. Like sometimes we get these buns and they just come out. So that's how fresh things are made here. And that I do not want to change at all, no matter how many stores we are. So to open multiple stores, it's quite hard to answer that question. How do I make a burger taste the same here as it would if we opened in Sydney? How do we replicate that freshness and that quality? And that's just something that I have to figure out moving forward with growing. But I do not want to veer away from that. There's certain oils that we use, non-cholesterol oils, that even though they're a lot more expensive than other oils we could use, I care what people are eating. I care what my family are eating. I care what you're eating. I care what everyone's eating. So as an owner, I push really hard for that to all my suppliers.
Sorry, I'm out of breath. I just want to quickly come out to say thank you very much for everyone for coming out
coming down tonight. Sorry, I said something before, but there weren't really people here. I don't know if you're here to listen to the switch band or to come get some food, but thank you anyway. Thank you so much. thank you for the switch band for coming out tonight. I'm lost for words, but I just wanted to say sorry to everyone waiting in line for the food. Sorry, long wait. We got a little ass kitchen in here with about 12 people in there trying to bang out your orders. So I just wanted to apologize. It's coming, the engine's burning, but we'll get there. But I just want to say thank you so much, everyone, for coming. Thank you to Swiss Fan, thank you to all my boys for everyone, all the trainers for helping me. I love everyone, man.
The growth has started actually. So I can't actually announce yet, but there is a second store on the way. And I don't think it's gonna happen next year, I think it's gonna happen this year. It's gonna be a lot bigger. It's gonna be, so this is the prototype. So this is always gonna be the first one that we get, and we're gonna nut out all the hard things and find what's right and what's wrong and what's worked for us and what. And so this is gonna be the prototype. The next shop is gonna be the Bentley of them, man. It's just gonna have everything that we don't have here, everything to make life easier, to get orders out more efficiently. We're gonna have a dine-in there. There's gonna be possibly, I'm not too sure. We're just trying to work it out, but we're still gonna keep the same atmosphere, the same live music, the same really, same fresh, the same quality. But the store that we found, it's actually a lot bigger and there's so much more we can do with it. And it's in a good location for a lot of people out that way. If you know, you know. So yeah, so a second store is on the cards and possibly a third. But moving forward, I do have big plans for Grubbies. I really do.
Look good, man. Shout out to everyone that helped. We finally put it all together, baby. Let's go.
And I don't actually have a secret. The truth is I work from 9 in the morning to about 1, 2 o'clock in the morning. I work throughout the morning to the night, so every day. So there's not much, there's not like I'm just sitting at home making money. There's hard work that goes into this. But my main thing is having a go. If I never went behind my wife's back and threw every single cent that we had in the bank and have a crack at this, none of this would be possible. None of it, like none of us would be sitting here. But this, my life has changed, not just for myself, but for people around me, my family that I look after and our staff. Our life's changed. Just that switch of mindset, you know, like if you're a truck driver, why not own the truck? You know, if you do this or do that, why not own the company or do it? Like, you can still do what you're doing, but you can, and there's ways and means that you can get around to making these things possible. So if anyone can learn anything from me, I hope it's that they just have a go. Whatever they're passionate about, figure it out. It's always going to be a risk. It's never going to be an easy kind of like, I'm going to be a photographer, I'm going to quit my job and I'm going to make heaps of money. It's never going to be like that. It's all right to make mistakes. Make mistakes, make them fast, 90% forward thinking, and you'll do well. But I'm always open to conversations. If anyone's aspiring to do anything and want to be anything, come and see me, especially when I open in the food industry. I've learned a lot the hard way, and so I really, I encourage you all, get out there, have a crack, come and see me. I'm happy to help anyone, but have a go. That's probably my main advice to anyone.
Wait, cleaners, G.
M-ways.
I actually want to say one more thing. I want to say a huge thank you to the people that actually make Grubbies what it is, and that's my staff. I have 3 young boys that are all in school. I have 2 older boys. I've got 3 girls who are all my sisters. And I have an amazing support system at home. And Grubbies is nothing without these guys. I honestly, they come here, they know what time I get here in the morning, they know what time I leave at night. And these guys, even though it's not part of their job, they will be here early in the morning and night, and they pump so hard to get the food out and at the quality that I expect of them. And in the volumes that we do, you know, we're currently up to a ton a week of meat we're selling. It's not easy, and a lot of these guys don't have much experience in the kitchen, and we've trained them. But I just really want to say that Grubbies isn't Grubbies without these guys, and I really want to give like massive props to my staff. I love them a lot, And that is probably the true secret to Grubbies, is that I've got a really good team that push really hard and work really hard, and they buy into the dream, they buy into what we're trying to do, they know we're trying to go here to there, and they're all bought into it and they're all working hard. So I just want to dedicate a little part of this to them, because I am nothing without them, and I am nothing without my family at home, I'm nothing without my friends, and I thank everyone that has supported me from the very start till now, because without you all, none of this is possible, especially during COVID, especially during the time that we're working. It means the world to me. So, from the bottom of my heart, I thank you all.
My brown brother, that's my uso, that's my doko, my tangane, yeah, I got him cause I love my brown brother. We came up from the gutter, had no one but each other, cause it's my brown brother.